Hey everybody, welcome to another Stoneface Reactions. I'm Griffin, that's Theta, and we're here to watch some more 86. Last time, the episode was I'm With You, where we got all the lore dump. Lena tells Shin how Shoiru saved her life in a Legion ambush that killed her father, and how he was kind and compassionate and wanted nothing more than to go back home and see Shin again. She also learns that the Nozen family immigrated to the Republic from the Empire before the war, and possibly lived in the capital of District 1. Just then, Shin warns Lena of a Legion offensive, despite the fact that she hasn't received any notifications from command. Shin also warns Lena to cut her para-raid link with him due to the presence of Black Sheep in the Legion, but Lena insists on staying connected. However, during the battle, Lena begins to hear the voices of people in distress, including Kaye's last words, and goes into shock. Though traumatized by the experience, Lena works up the courage to contact Shin again, and he explains due to a near-death experience, he can now hear the voices of the dead from the Legion, which is how he can predict their movements. Furthermore, the Legion's programming is based on how a human brain works. Because of this, the Legions have been able to copy the brains of people they have killed on the battlefield, imprinting their victims' last thoughts into their programming and creating Black Sheep and Shepherd models that have far superior performance and intelligence. The Legion is in fact far larger and more intelligent than the Republic realizes, and has already evolved a method of exceeding their original lifespans, meaning the Republic's defeat is inevitable. Hearing all this, Lena resolves to work with Shin to destroy the Legion's Shepherd commanders with 1 year to end the war for good. Later that night, it is revealed that Shin bears a scar on his neck from the time where Shoiru attempted to strangle him. Oh boy, and that is a mouthful and a lot of stuff to take in. They're all doomed, the robots are also zombies, and this is wild, right?
I guess the fact that we heard... God, what's her name?
Kaye?
Yeah, but you know me, I'm trying to remember them by their handles and not that... And she's like Kira Bloosh or something like that.
Uh-huh.
Anyway, the fact that they heard her voice must mean that they didn't torch her body as they said that they did.
Mm-hmm.
Just putting that. I'm gonna throw this out there right now. I've had a pretty harrowing morning, so if I seem just a bit more out of it than normal, or I don't pick something up, just take that as a grain of salt and know that I'll be back in prime fashion next if recording.
Right, right.
We all know that I have a list of things to go over here, but Griff, why don't you tell me your thoughts first before we go into me time?
I mean, right now I'm just thinking about, like, all the externalities of everything we learned, which is, of course, you know, what else is happening in the world still if there's this legion of killer robots that takes people's brains and puts them into them to continue making more of itself? How is the Republic the only place that knows? How doomed are these people? What exactly is happening politically inside the city as well is also kind of a feature. I think we spent a lot of time last time talking about how, if the robots breach the walls, it is basically completely and immediately over because no one inside has any possible experience doing anything military.
It was also one of my points in our second recording where I mentioned, what about the rest of the world?
Mm-hmm. There, we learned a whole lot, but it just has me asking more questions, including, like, when did the Empire build this? How did the Empire completely fade away if they have all the killer robots on their side, ostensibly?
They said that.
Mm-hmm.
They answered that question already. I'm having a hard time remembering exactly what it was. Sometime near the start of the war, the Legion destroyed the Empire.
I thought they just said, quote, we lost contact with them.
Yeah, I'm pretty sure in, like, the same paragraph of sentence, they said that they thought that the Empire was destroyed.
Yeah, it was a lot of supposition from the people and world, which is perfectly fair. And that's about as far as we have right now in terms of knowledge.
I mean, it's also coming from unreliable narrators, so...
Exactly. So, yeah, it could be completely different. Maybe the rest of the world is just like, no, we're going to go ahead and surround this place with killer robots. Who knows? There's a lot of extra info. The fact we have advanced brain science here is already kind of on the table. anything could happen at this point. I think we could have, like, any dead character come back at any time in villainous form. Which has me thinking, so Lena's father is definitely going to show up. Like, 100%.
You keep saying.
I keep saying. It feels like if we're building all this knowledge, it would be a shame to not have that dramatic beat in there specifically for her to get further traumatized. It would be great. So, that's kind of what's going through my head, Theta. Is there anything going through yours?
Well, as I said, I've written it all out, and I'm just going to do what I normally do and just read my thoughts verbatim.
There you go.
Undertaker's scar kind of matches where Lena wears the Pararade stuff. I feel like there is a misdirection that the brother choked him and left the scar, but choking doesn't leave that kind of mark, unless they tried to hang him or something. Trust me, as someone who's familiar with neck scars.
Mm-hmm. Oh yeah, no, 100%. Is... Like, that is the scar of his head getting removed for the robots or something.
It is possible Undertaker had a Pararade thing, and it burnt in, and that's why he can hear the dead amongst the Legion. Or did they try and take him, and didn't fully assimilate him in, and that's why?
Yeah, that's what I'm banking on.
Could it be possible that Command knows about the whole zombie Legion thing, and that it is the real reason why they won't supply 86 with intel, like the maps and such? Any information that you give them would just be information that the Legion would have after they capture the 86er. Hell,
that would
do
start
you,
to make a lot of sense.
Hell, do you think that is also that is why so many high-ranking people seem to be drinking and fucking with such abandon? Even Annette is constantly pushing good food and relationships in front of Lena, like there is no time left. Hell, she's on her 9th fiancé now. Share image. Hold on.
At the same time, that girl also seems to just be incredibly in the moment anyway.
There's a picture of all of Annette's fiancés. You can denote the wide range of ages. And I will hopefully remember to put this up on the overlay at some point.
A lot of them are blurred, and the fact that they all have silver hair does not help.
Well,
but yeah, absolutely.
What else? I mean, they would all have silver hair. What other kind of hair would they have?
It makes it harder to distinguish their age, is what I mean. When they're, like, all completely blurred up. But yeah, no, like, I feel like our scientist girl, that's just her personality, but I am on to you. I feel
you're
like...
You're on to me? Shit. I better burn the evidence.
I feel like what you're saying sounds completely true, and we literally just need one character to show up and just say, like, we're all gonna die, takes a drink.
I mean, in fairness, you only, it completely. You only assume that's her personality, only because she's acted that way since we've met her, which has been literally the span of 3 days. She could have been entirely different before this.
Oh, gosh. I'm sorry, the statement's like, you only assume that because of all the evidence you've seen.
Yeah.
This is a great statement.
This is a show that over 5 episodes has hit us with so much world building that the evidence that you've seen is not enough to determine what's going on. Mm-hmm. So, right, if we turn around and Annette has a basement full of dead bodies, oh man, that's not her personality. No, it's not the personality you've seen. It's the personality that she has, though.
I guess my only closing statement on that is that she hasn't seemed like she is acting in an unnatural manner. Like, she doesn't... everything she's doing, she's acting like a normal person who is interacting with a friend and being a little bit pushy.
Once again, she's sitting in front of informational diagrams, which in reality are telling you to buy PowerPoint presentations. So...
she's also, like, one of the researchers onto the, Pararade stuff, so if anyone, like, knows what the robots are doing, it is probably actually her. What else you got?
Also, they said before that they weren't allowed to bury their dead, Well, with the Legion playing scavengers with their brains, looks like that played out well.
Yeah, the cruelty is the point, but the point is to stop the robot zombies.
I still have to wonder what Fido is. Is he a Legion brain capture that somehow remained loyal? Or is he an Alba test subject that they decided not to repeat? How likely is it that it's really an AI, given everything we've seen at this point?
At this point, my bet is that it is a dog brain scan.
It talks. Dogs don't talk.
Not until they're robots.
No, I think your best bet there, Griff, would have been that's only the personality you've seen of a dog.
That's only all the evidence of dogs you've seen up until now. Dogs could be entirely different, Theta.
In episode 1, before even the title drop, we hear their handler shouting for them to enter the battle and die like pigs before getting confused, asking what's going on, and then shouting for them to shut up. We had no idea what was going on at the time, but it seems obvious now that that was their last handler experiencing the voices of the dead for the first time.
Yeah, I definitely can agree there.
Also, in episode 1, Lena's uncle describes the thing that causes the squadron to lose handlers as the Reaper, so it seems fairly clear that people have talked about it, at least. And the higher-ups know about this ghost story, he calls it a ghost story, of Voices of the Dead, he also calls it Voices of the Dead, as they call it even in the first episode.
Yeah, that's... If you have people with these pararate things communicating with squads out in the field, there's no hiding the evidence, is ultimately what it comes down to.
Well, especially... Well, there is some hiding the evidence, considering they say that some of them commit suicide. And how many of them have actually committed suicide and weren't just shut up?
Oh, yeah. Like, how many of these are just like, oh, yeah, no, they're about to spill the beans. Get rid of them. So Lena's in more danger with that line of thought.
Well, she's in danger anyway. They've got a ticking clock. Well, I mean, they Very do and they don't. Danger. The ticking clock is kind of made up. I mean... This is a made-up story, but you know what I'm saying.
Yeah.
They're saying you've got like a year or two, but I mean, that's Undertaker making an educated guess how long the other 86ers are going to be able to hold out. And then, you know, the fight comes to the cannons at the walls.
Eventually, things are going to go really bad, and you know what? I almost expect that to just be the season closer.
I guess this country doesn't have nukes.
Definitely not the way they're talking. Otherwise, they would have used them.
Well, I don't even mean, like, in the base aspect. I mean, like, high-orbit EMP. Mm-hmm. That would at least shut some shit down. The Legion doesn't seem to be... Like, I think you need,
they
like,
don't have
heavy...
missile technology, as far as I've seen.
I think you need heavy grounding to be able to survive an EMP, because that's how most, like, shielded stuff works, is that it's shielded to... make the high-charge electrons pass through or around down to the ground.
I'm definitely not up to my real-world literature of how that kind of, like, electric wave, like, would be dissipated, but...
I'm not well-read into it, but I did the minor... Remember when I ran the Myriad song?
Yeah.
And we were on that post-apocalypse world where they nuked themselves to shit? And I based the entire area about Cheyenne Mountain. So I was kind of doing research on the inside of Cheyenne Mountain, like which places would still have computers and shit that worked, and which places would just be, you know.
Yeah.
Sorry, my brain stopped working. I would say recruits, but recruits was the wrong word. Refugees, which places were just holding refugees and shit. Yeah. Well, you say that we don't see any missile technology, but remember, the conventional army lost in 2 weeks, so...
They could literally not have anything left.
Did you ever read World War Z?
No, I didn't.
Well, the Battle of Yonkers, where the U.S. military tries to, you know, pump itself up to the U.S. media by having a giant fight just outside of New York City, which is in a small area called Yonkers. So you have basically the undead population of New York, which is basically the population of New York pouring out down this road at a wholly unprepared military that's using, like, shit that doesn't make sense to use against zombies just to show off the might of the U.S. military. And they just fucking fall apart and fail in national confidence that the military is going to save us from the zombie apocalypse falls apart right there. And it literally leads into a section of the book called The Great Panic.
Yeah.
So yeah, our military, or their military, loses in 2 weeks, which could just mean that nothing worked. Like, we know that they have the swarm of butterfly, the locust swarm of butterfly sort of things that block out communications. Maybe those act as a localized EMP that'll just nullify missile technology. Maybe missiles can't lock on. Well, I don't know.
There might be a very good reason somewhere in there. It's just not a thing that we've
seen. That also sounds like it wouldn't work, because we had an episode 2 where she's telling him the locations of heavy artillery that are firing on them from a long distance. And he's saying that they can identify our locations by this closed wave transmission that you're using, so please stop talking to us.
Mm-hmm.
However, in hindsight, that also could have been a double bluff, given that he's trying to keep her off the radio so she doesn't hear the voices of the dead. So in fact, that could have been...
That's a good read. That's a real good read.
Yeah, that just occurred to me now that that could just have been a lie he's telling her so she doesn't hear things that she wouldn't understand. Like, she doesn't have the context for Cujo. I can't remember his handle at the moment. But she wouldn't have context for Cujo's voice coming up, because it would just be, who else is on the radio? You know, that sort of thing.
Yeah, yeah. And of course, like, the third read when you're watching it is definitely to the tune of, like, oh yeah, maybe I'm just trying to get her off the comm so I can do my own thing. Which probably is the incorrect read at the end of the day.
Yeah, but I don't think she actually ever has that. She never says to anyone, or thinks it to herself, you know, they're just trying to get rid of me. Even when they even when they actively try to get rid of her, she doesn't think it to herself.
Yep.
There was another minor thing that came up that I saw people talk about, but I don't think we ever mentioned the two people that are making out on the stairwell.
Mm-hmm.
What was that, 2 episodes ago? Or an episode ago?
Yeah, it's been a bit.
Yeah. She gets flustered when she sees them. The shadows of them against the wall actively change to Shin and Lena's shadows.
Yeah, yeah, that checks out. That was the context of it. She saw them, she was talking with Shin, she was having thoughts, and immediately did the anime bluster moment.
Yeah, just, we never mentioned that the shadows changed, that she saw herself in the shadows.
The story really wants them to hook up. So, any more thoughts?
I guess this is just a little minor point, but it does seem to surprise people. Honestly, I don't give a fuck. But, did you know the writer of this is a woman?
Oh, okay.
I guess...
what has she worked on before?
I don't know. I only saw people bringing up that, hey, did you know the person who wrote this is a woman? I was like, okay. I don't know what else they wrote. I guess it's maybe surprising that a woman wrote a hard military story, but then again, there's women in the military, so I don't understand where that's the thing either.
Then again, what this feels like is a drama romance on the backdrop of a war story.
I would say no. A lot of people who were pushing this as a great story were pushing it as it rings true to the experience of having been on a battlefield. Mm-hmm. So, you know, the losses and trying to get through PTSD and that sort of shit. Yeah. Like, I feel like the romance element that you just mentioned, the drama romance, isn't really the main thing, except for maybe episode 3. And then episode 3, it's just because we're trying to sell how important this character's death is going to be once they die at the end of the episode.
Yeah, like, what we really have here is, like, five different, like, story angles, and all of them are good. Like, we got, like, the drama, the romance I mentioned, we got, like, the inner circle politics stuff going on, we've got social drama, and then, of course, we have the war story. So we got a lot of different angles, and I don't think any of them are actually valued any more than others right now.
Yeah, I mean, the drama romance is clearly the least valued of them.
Yeah. Alright. Any more thoughts?
That's it.
Alright then. In that case, let's go ahead and wrap it up here and get watching. But before we do, be sure to hit that like button, hit that subscribe button, and comment down below to feed that algorithm. On top of all that, if you want more episodes like this, unfiltered, uncensored, and uncut, as well as some early access stuff, you can go ahead and check us out over on the Patreon. It's just $5 a month, but no pressure. It's all to support the channel, just a little bit extra.
Click the link down below, join the Discord, talk to us directly. We're lonely people. Sometimes we need a little bit of encouragement. Almost Christmas.
Santa brought me death robots. This is the best Christmas ever.
That was 2148, right?
Or 44, maybe.
Well, if it's 44, it's the past. If it's 48, it's the current present. Hell, if it's 48, it's 6 months in the future from the last episode.
Yeah, this has a past scene kind of vibe.
No, he also looks younger. When he has emotion on his face. So it'd be 2 years after the flashback of last episode, and 4 years in the past of our current time. Oh, maybe this is where he gets strangled. Oh, his brother.
Yep.
Merry Christmas. Already has a scar, though.
And missing the head. Lisa.
God, they gotta fix so many of those things. Remember, the opening changes.
Yeah, let's see how many people are dead now.
I mean, it changes in the course of, like, a millisecond, so don't blink.
Yeah. No, nobody else has died yet, right?
I don't know what I know about, but we're currently in the past. I tell you this, I can't play a what's changed image game in 3 seconds, so.
Mm-hmm. Yeah, that's something you gotta do out on the side. And obviously, we're gonna see when they die real soon.
Well, not if we're all in the past.
Right. I keep trying to look for more details on that geo map, but, like, there ain't nothing.
Well, I already freeze-framed it. So. I already told you the big difference to me was the U.S. and Russia.
Mm-hmm. What if that's where the rest of the Legion is, like, taking them over?
I mean... Wait,
well, that's a lot of dead.
Wait. That was more people.
That was like six, yeah.
Yeah, that's...
We're gonna have some deaths today!
They wouldn't change it in the episode they die in, would they?
Let's find out.
That'd be insane. Especially now that we know to look for it so early. Because I think it was only four dead people before. Right, I went over it, right?
Yeah, yeah.
There was two, and then one when Kiyoi.
I love that they're trying to, like, emote a little bit with the robots and their emotions.
Right, I'm the present again.
Ruskinia.
All right. Hey, theory. Everything that's happening to the 86, not real. They are all actually brains inside their machines.
I was going to say in the Matrix, which I guess is technically kind of the same.
And the reason you're not supposed to go out there is because then you'll see that.
I don't think so. I'm
waiting
but that's
like the second twist, you know?
I think that's literally on the level of your heaven is another dimension thing.
I'm allowed to have the wild theories. They're allowed to have a nice barbecue.
So happy start episodes do tend to mean that someone's gonna die, according to our previous thing.
Oh, absolutely.
And to our previous rundown, a person should die every 1 to 2 episodes. So we're due for one. Yeah, we set these two like each other.
Oh, one of them's gonna die then.
Do you think Snow Witch figured out what was going on, and that's why she's out here? Okay, yeah, I'm sorry. Not present. Just slightly before present. Right? What month is it?
Given the trees right now, it might actually be some sort of fall month.
No, I mean, when it popped up earlier.
I don't remember.
I've literally got a listing of months and days here. No, I'm not talking about the normal calendar, I mean for the show.
Now the 86 are like, what if everyone is fake on the inside?
I mean, the real danger here is that people we haven't heard talk before are talking.
Oh yeah, no, they're obviously meeting up with another squad here, and that squad's gonna hold die.
I wonder why he cares enough to cover up his neck. Especially since everybody knows.
Yeah, he could be self-conscious. That's fine.
Doesn't kind of seem like the kind of guy.
Maybe it could also hurt to touch. So covering it up might help.
Hurts to touch. Let me put something abrasive around it.
It looks pretty loose. Yeah, come on, you started the backstory, you gotta give it to us now.
We already know that one. You said it before. Plus, we saw it literally in the opening of the show. Well, that seems not like a great thing to say to somebody, given.
Okay, here's why he's wearing it. So he can dramatically pull it down. Oh, I just realized that's a Santa outfit.
Yeah, this has to be slightly past, say, a couple months ago.
This is just like a cute, adorable moment for them all.
Yeah. Just to buddy up for them all to die.
Exactly.
Hey, Fida was there too. 4 months. I said a couple. It was four. I was close. Cicadas. You think she's gonna fuck up because of it, and that's what causes people to die?
I'm not sure if I got that vibe yet. Wait, what was that?
It's not a vibe, it's trying to read into it.
They had actual, like, walking humanoid things on the ground there.
Guy, we haven't seen too much of you, and you're talking way too much.
Oh. It's not the time to be snacking, man.
Yeah, literally, why were you eating?
Oh, that is just wildly creepy.
Yeah, not exactly humanoid. I mean, they are humanoid, just not exactly human. Mouths? Why
actually?
Why their mouths got shit coming out of them? Oh shit, was that Black Dog?
Yeah.
Fluff, man. No, okay, that was Burnt Tail, not Black Dog. Burnt Tail looks like Black Dog. Trying to shoot yourself in the head? There you go.
Gracefully turning off the brain communication before suicide, too, is also a nice little detail.
I mean,
oh, that's two dead.
I mean, it's good to be safe. Oh, it was Black Dog. The only grouping that I would knew about and it was like with. God, he died so fucking early. They've been like doing something together every episode. Man, she wasn't fully successful killing herself either.
Oh, just even worse. I am very glad we have this back shot. Oh, this episode's getting creepy. I'm fine, says the person who's not fine at all.
I guess it's just easier not to make connections.
Finally, Daiya reached the
Explains why there were so many more people in the opening. I guess that's something we can look forward to spoiling ourselves with now.
Spoiler, people die in the show. No.
Well, no, now we can literally identify who's gonna die before they die. Boy's gotta give himself some head. Okay, yeah, but your body shouldn't be able to... Is that just a nightmare?
Oh, that is uncomfortably tragic.
Oh, so a month in the future. From where we were. Last episode.
Just offloading stuff.
Oh, so number 10. That's right, the last one was a child.
Oh, that's a cover statement if ever there was one.
Fido was a test bed for one of her previous fiancés. They're all dying. She's killing them.
Oh, that expression, that statement. There's no next year.
Well, we kind of already know that anyway.
I know, but she knows.
Playing guess who with your squadron, huh? Surprisingly that she didn't write their names down on the pieces of paper, though. The people wouldn't like hearing the guns going off.
Yeah.
Why don't you double down and tell him about the voices just to make sure that he knows?
Change of the subject, darn.
戦隊全機を当該拠点に進出させ、速やかにこれを殲滅せよ。
待ってください。これまでの戦死者の補充もまだなのにですか？なぜ我々には他の隊のように補充がないのですか？
レギオンが前進するための足がかりとしての拠点だ。完成前の今撃滅。
Because we want to operate on Undertaker. So the sooner he dies, the sooner we get to do that.
彼らを救いたいのだろう。ミリーズ少佐。違ったかね？
了解しました。
So, didn't even bring it up, huh?
Nope. Didn't come close.
Great, another visual representation of the people dead.
その レギオンの拠点については、こちらでも把握しています。まず罠でしょうね。
罠だと分かっているのに、その誘いに乗って攻撃するのですか？
放置する方が厄介かもしれませんから。
Yeah, just because of the trap doesn't mean it's not a real base.
できればよかったのですが、許可が下りなくて。
ああ、あれ？今までも使ってるとこなんか見たことないし、もう使い物にならないんじゃないの？
そうですか。
まあ気にすんな。
別に最初から当てにしてないよ。
ストレスはお肌の敵ですよ。
Yeah, the fact that they're also behind a minefield isn't helpful.
では今日はこれで。
Clearly, you just have the 86 go at back there, grab them and tow them up.
That's what I was saying, but they're behind a minefield. That's not what I was saying, that's what I was thinking. But the fact they're behind a minefield makes them a risk to try and steal.
Tai?
Shosa, 大丈夫ですか？声が少しピリピリしているようなので。Shosa こそ、今夜はちゃんと寝てください。
Aw, I'll send back nice words to them.
それで一息ついては。何です？
いえ、お兄様みたいだなって。チョコレートをくれたんです。私が辛かった時に。
Yeah, this is a great subject.
やっぱり兄弟なんですね。辛いのはあなたの方なのに。
You really are like the person who wants you dead.
甘いものが好きなのですよね。
兄が。
I was trying to give you a break, so let me broach the touchiest subject I can. My brother was a psychopath who tried to kill me. Why is he still on the board? He's dead.
I guess because he's the target behind enemy lines. Lighthearted anime romance to wash out the deaths of the other rest of the episode.
Again, third reminder of the show of the people who've died, so just don't forget. Okay, carving something into your chocolate's fine. Coloring it blue is a bit weird. I'd be afraid to.
If I were to take it as a real shot, I would say, like, oh, maybe something weird has happened to her vision because of the pair of Raid messing with her brain. But, like, this is just an artistic shot.
Well, yeah, if something weird happened to her vision, I'm like, what the hell is the crinkle in her eye on the bottom right-hand corner?
Her eye is melting, that's why.
Well, that's
whole brain is on fire.
As you understand, Griff, this is all fake reality. They're all seeing the world that doesn't exist.
Everyone was in the Matrix all along, Theta.
Well, I mean, to be fair, if that was true, then probably nobody died then.
Everyone was programmed to begin with.
Well, I mean, more so that if you're just using them for something, then... Okay, no... No preview or anything like that. Sorry, that episode seemed to go really fast, but again, the moment that we saw that more people were in the dead people field, it was instantly like, wait, what? You don't do that in the episode they die in, because now we're just looking for it. You do it in the next episode. It's insanity.
Have fun identifying every character that dies, then, before they do.
Well, we're looking at it from behind, so it's literally size and hair color. It's like,
yeah,
okay.
You gotta go by silhouette, for sure.
Well, we're quickly running out of people, so... especially if they're not getting replaced. As she just said, had the whole argument with her uncle about... But yeah, Black Dog is the one that stands out to me, because the other two, as far as I understand, haven't talked all that much. But Black Dog has been in the whole relationship, or trying to have a relationship, with Snow Queen, and now that's not happening.
I like the thing that you brought up earlier, which is that, wait a second, what if they're trying to intentionally get Undertaker killed so that they can take his head back and do the experiments and whatever, and the higher command is also in on this? And that's why they're doing these specific things and vetoing specific other things. And I'm just thinking to the way the story has presented Undertaker so far as the last remaining person in every squad he's in. Everyone around him dies, and then he moves to the next one. Our season's gonna end. Everyone will be dead. Undertaker's still alive. He goes to the next squad, and we still have our handler. And those are the two who get to just see another swath of people die around them.
Well, probably not. We have, what, 6 squads of 6 under him? Mm-hmm. So 36 people, and we've lost 6, so a squad's worth. And how many episodes are in this season?
There are 11 total.
So probably 11 people will die. Probably a little less than that, out of 30 that remain. So I don't think so. I mean, unless they break their 1-2 streak, 1-2 episodes per death streak, and just go ham on a big death. Like, we watch the opening, and the field is just fucking full of people all of a sudden, and we know, oh man, last episode was so fun, but now everyone's about to die.
There is a non-zero chance that there's an episode where they open up back at base, they're having, like, breakfast or something, they're getting everything ready, and then an artillery shell hits, and 5 of them are dead.
Sure, there's an opening to an episode where it's Shin walking towards the hangar and nobody's there. Just Fido sitting there, cocked on the side like somebody would be sitting on top of him waving, but they're not there.
Yeah, there's like a lot of potential for even more tragedy. We've already gone to the point of failed suicide followed up by assisted suicide. We can't get much darker. But we can.
No, yeah, definitely we can. We're still safely within the realm of Girl and Panzer, just without the death element.
It's still silly to be comparing over to that, because every time I think of, like, Girl and Panzer, I'm thinking just like, oh yeah, you know, totally bloodless violence kind of fun games or whatever. And here, this is definitely about as real of a war story as I've seen for a while.
As we talked about before we watched today.
So, I think that's all that's on my brain. Data, anything else on yours you want to give out?
I mean, Annette basically gave a very thinly veiled threat. Don't tell anybody about your para-raid experiences, or we'll cut your brain open and transfer you.
Yeah. That's in the future.
And of course, now she's on Fiancé number 10.
Fiancé number 11 is going to be a hardliner politician who will totally do the cutting open someone's brain thing.
I mean, or be me. I have no idea who the fuck this is yet. I'm based on somebody, I know that. I don't remember who it is. You're based on a guy named Griffin, who I'm still not sure we've seen in the show yet.
I'm just going to have to straight look him up now. Just
well,
to make
don't,
sure
because
appears.
That'll be a spoiler. You'll find out if he's alive or dead. I already told you the website, they're just like on the ball with that shit.
Oh, yeah.
But we know he's been in the paperwork. Like, number 6 or 7 is Griffin. I don't remember this guy's name. Yeah. And we haven't seen anybody with an eye patch that I remember.
I guess we'll get there one day.
Also, knowing the fact, I don't remember if this guy's supposed to be an Alba or not. So, if he is an Alba, it can't be a combat eye patch because he's not going out into the field. It means I've done something stupid and like tripped and fell into the edge of a table. Or I am an Alba and I've got some sort of weird military uniform for some reason. I mean, not an Alba, I'm 86er and I got some sort of weird military
Maybe
uniform.
Maybe you're an Empire officer or something.
Apparently, all I know is I'm supposed to be an asshole.
Alright then. So, I guess on that note, let's go ahead and wrap up here for today. This has been Stoneface Tractions, everybody. I'm Griffin, that's Theta, and we'll catch you next time. See you around. Hey everybody, thanks for watching another Stoneface Tractions. If you have an idea of another video we could go ahead and watch, go ahead and put it in the comments down below, and we'll add it to the wheel. Be sure to like, comment, and subscribe, and let us know what you thought about this video, what parts you liked. And until then, we'll see you next time. Is this too goofy?